So remember how in Saturday's video I told you that the new Red Dead Online update could very well be delayed and we are looking at nothing but shameful Tuesday content updates until then? Well, that narrative has changed today, and I have some really juicy intel to share with you all today, and it has to do with new content. Something I really wasn't expecting to say on this Monday morning to you all, Rockstar actually teased new ability cards for Red Dead Online. And I can already see the questions popping up, so sit tight as we dive into everything you need to know about Red Dead, all the changes since our Tuesday update video, including these new teased ability cards, a new patch coming. The one I mentioned now for over a week is now ready and live in-game, but there is a twist to it, so let's talk about it all. Firstly, new ability cards. Major shout out to the user ButTheBenz on the GTA forums. He posted this image accompanied by his post, which said the following. I just saw this on my social club, but I rarely go on there, and so I don't know if it's been there for long, ever before, or whatever. Upon taking a closer look at this image and analyzing the ability cards featured under the semi-auto shotgun in the bottom right, we can clearly see two ability cards that are currently not in-game. And apologize for the quality of this image, this is the best I could get off of the social club itself. The reddish pink card is the current A Moment to Recuperate card already in-game, and I actually had a whole part of this discussion centered around what this card could be, but then I realized it's already in-game, so rest in peace. But nonetheless, the first card on the left, the green recovery ability card, we can see an older man surrounded by two children or baby angels. And they're wrapping him in some type of shroud, and his facial expression appears to be neutral. Judging by how the current recovery abilities work in Red Dead Online at the moment, this card will in some way allow the player to replenish health, stamina, or Deadeye faster, or be able to gain extra of a specific trait by inducing another on a player. So, for example, our first example would be a card like Strange Medicine. You regain a lot of health whenever you inflict damage. And our second example would be a recovery card like Peak Condition. Sprinting uses less stamina, and you deal more damage. And again, I'm not quite sure the specifics of this card, but I fill up all three passive slots on my ability card loadout with recovery ability cards like Eye for an Eye, Strange Medicine, and Cold Blooded, and so I'm very curious and I would love to try out this card. But moving our attention to the second ability card teased in the Rockstar Social Club image, it's a yellow damage ability card that features a man who reminds me of either the Strange Man or Josiah Trelawney, and probably because of the mustache and the top hat. There are no ability cards currently in-game that feature prominent story mode characters as the artwork on the card itself, and this one most likely isn't the exception, but we have limited stuff to go off of right now. And either way, this man with a top hat is melting. His face is dripping off the bottom of the card. No, I don't think this card will turn your opponents or any enemy for that matter into glue and watch them turn into a puddle on the floor, but I do think that this card can leave damage dealt on an enemy over time. Similar to a poison arrow, but working in a different way. In Red Dead, you shoot a poison arrow at an animal, it runs away, slows down, collapses, and then quickly dies shortly thereafter. And currently, the poison arrow is the only thing in-game with this kind of ability, short of lighting someone on fire, of course. But with this card, this is the answer for that, perhaps. There doesn't necessarily need to be poison-tipped bullets for weapons, when you have the constant damage ability card. Maybe on a per-shot basis, you're doing less damage than normal rounds, high-velocity rounds, or express rounds, but perhaps with this new damage ability card, you can either keep up the pressure and suppress better in firefights, as enemies hit by your rounds won't be back in the fight for longer whiles of time, or perhaps even your bullets slow enemy movement and briefly disable a player or enemy's sprint when you shoot at them. And again, those are just my thoughts, just my speculation here, but I would love to hear yours. What do you think each card is all about here? List your predictions and speculations for the recovery card and the damage card. For better or for worse, the last passive slot on the image is locked, so we don't see any tease at any defense ability card. Take that how you want. Changing gears though, with the addition of Red Dead Online Frontier Pursuits, we saw 9 new ability cards added to the game, and for the sake of comprehensiveness and the fact that the community is totally different than it was 8 months ago, I'll list them right now. The cards are Sharpshooter, Kick in the Butt, Live for the Fight, Friends for Life, Fool Me Once, Iron Lung, Strength in Numbers, Gunslinger's Choice, and Ride Like the Wind. It was also mentioned the week of Frontier Pursuits update by Red Dead Online leaker and reputable Rockstar Games insider Tez Funds 2 that more Stranger missions and ability cards were still yet to be released. The Stranger Missions for Free Roam, where Tilly Jackson, Obadiah Hinton, which is the guy at the Elysian Pool shantytown with the big growth under his face, I'm pretty sure that's the guy, and then one other that I can't recall the name of. And unfortunately, we have still not seen these strangers yet, but we never also found out the names of what those new ability cards were yet to be released either. But now we know their names as well. So amazing find by Bud the Benz, and the two ability cards found on the Red Dead Online Social Club website, they're still yet to be named, but TezFun2 has revealed two confirmed ability card names. The two confirmed names of the known total four ability cards for right now coming to Red Dead Online are the Eternal Flame and a Person of Conviction. The Eternal Flame appears to be a damage card, again signified by the yellow color on the card itself, and then a Person of Conviction, very obviously a Deadeye ability card. Get ready, with these four and potentially more cards, the meta may very well change here in Red Dead. With fans already guessing what these cards could be about, of course Eternal Flame hinting at something with fire, whether increased flammable damage or increased flammable damage at range, I'll throw my hat in the ring here and I'll agree. I think it will have something to do with damage displacement with the use of explosive rounds, incendiary rounds, fire bottles, dynamite, etc. Just all around increased damage with explosive and fire throwables, maybe even toxic moonshine as well. As for a Person of Conviction, aren't we all? Seriously though, I actually have no idea what this Deadeye card could be for, so I'll leave it up to you all in the comments. So the question everyone is dying to know the answer for here is, when are these cards going to be released? Well, the long answer is, they could be in any number of updates. The next one, they could be dropped in the meantime, just like how Rockstar added the showdown modes and maps recently over the past month and a half to Red Dead. But the short answer is, it's doubtful we see these new ability cards get released until the major DLC update drops, and that could be a ways off, unfortunately. I'm always hopeful, but I think we just have a little while longer to wait for that big update. New York is still getting destroyed right now, and that's where Rockstar does their motion capture work, or at least that's where their contracted mocap studio is based out of, New York City, so I wish the best of health to anyone there, and really you all right now. Stay safe, happy, and healthy. We do have additional information from TezFun2 on a new Red Dead Online update coming today. It's actually just released right now, so I have to modify my script here. But it's actually kind of confusing because it seemed like Rockstar was initially ready to push that update out, and then they retracted it, and then at least now, at the time of me recording this video, it is live in-game. It's 925 megabytes on PC. I'm not sure if it's for console as well. Tez thinks it's for PC only, so I will give you guys everything you need to know about this update. I wanted to make sure I have this intel out in the open for you all today, so apologies, I don't have any patch notes on hand in this video, since it did release like literally seconds ago. Because of that, expect patch notes to accompany all the discounts, bonuses, and other Red Dead Online changes with tomorrow's newswire about the Tuesday content update. That's where we'll wrap up today's video though. I would love to get your thoughts and opinions in the comments below regarding all of this update intel and what you think these four new ability cards are all about. I have so many thoughts, more than I already shared in this video, but I'll save that for another time. Speaking of tomorrow's update, I mean, I know it hasn't released yet. We'll find out tomorrow. I'll be sure to update you guys as soon as possible. I'm curious what you guys think about the discounts and bonuses that we're going to get. I mean, do you think they're going to be good? I'm kind of sick of Rockstar doing the roll XP bonuses. No one actually needs it, and the players who do need it, great. They can enjoy it, but I'm kind of upset at the fact that they isolate the players and ignore everyone who just wants something to take advantage of on their weekly event weeks. GTA Online, there's double and triple money bonuses for all sorts of their content, and although Red Dead isn't as developed, they can figure out ways to do different updates like that and discounts and bonuses that are just as exciting. Maybe double the materials you gather and give to Trader when you hunt animals, or, you know, double money from trading, double money from moonshining. We haven't had a double gold on daily challenges in a while. I don't think we'll ever get that again, but I would love to see something like that with gold, some type of boost with gold, not none of this pitiful 30, 40, 50% stuff. Where's the double and triple? I mean, I know a lot of people have money and gold already, but those are the kinds of updates I want to see. Those are the types of updates that Red Dead Online players deserve, especially for the fact that we've been sitting here since the beginning of December with a broken game, and I hope we see something like that very soon. Hopefully you all enjoyed the video, and if you did, hopefully I earned your like on it. A like rating would be very helpful for the channel and also make this video get recommended more, reach new viewers, and hopefully keep them informed on the exciting new changes and new ability cards coming to Red Dead Online. We all need something to get hyped and excited and to talk about, and hopefully this is it. So, of course, if you are new to the channel, consider hitting that subscribe button to stay up to date with all things Red Dead Online and Red Dead Redemption 2, and even Rockstar Games as a whole. We'll be sure to keep you guys up to date with updates, news, information, tips, tricks, and even leaks, and we'll keep you guys updated here on the channel daily, so make sure you hit that subscribe button. If you guys also want to follow me over on Twitch, Twitter, and Instagram, those are the best places to get connected with me outside of YouTube. I practically live on all three of those websites, and you can feel free to either strike up a conversation or even ask me a question. Whatever it may be, though, you can follow me at HazardousHDTV, and all of my social media links, including my Discord, can be found in the description down below. With that said, thank you all so much for watching. I hope you all have a fantastic day, and I will see you guys in the next Red Dead Online video. Adios, amigos.